Security. Magandang umaga po, magandang gabi po. Po si Mang Nino. At mag-live po tayo, sandali lang. Isi-set up ko lang po itong tunod na session natin. Na-delay po ang pag-model natin ng session 17. Dahil tayo po ay nagkaroon ng ibang aktibidad kaninang hapon. Tayo po ay nandiyon sa himlayan ng aking magulang, mga magulang. Dahil 1-year anniversary po ng aking nanay kanina at kami ay nagbabanglupsa. So, ngayon ko lang po ito pa ilalive. Then, after maybe isang oras or 2 o'clock, mag-ano na po tayo, mag-break. At ang break po natin hanggang umaga na po. So, maraming salamat po sa inyo na ng mga nanonood. Ayos ko ng pating mo. Ayos ko lang itong tawag dito. Kasi ano natin, 3D model na konti. So, nagawa na po natin yung forward ito, yung forward ball mounted MG. So dito sa ating mga nagawin lang po natin itong ibang bahagi, yung visor, at wala pa po tayong yung ating pong visor. Gagawin lang po natin. So, buksan ko lang muna sandali yung ating reference pictures para matignan natin kung ano yung ating sandali lang po. Tulad po ng dati, hindi naman po tayo speed modeling. Hindi po tayo speed modeling, tayo po ay naglibang lang in the sense na, well, serious na paglilibang, no? But, ganun din po talaga, talagang binibigyan din natin ito ng panahon, ng pag-3D. Kaya lang, hindi lang po tayo masyadong naghahaboy ng deadline. So anyway, itong portion na ito, ito po ang gagawin natin today or for this for this live. So ngayong live, itong portion na ito, ito yan. So dito may parang visor. Visor, hatch. Meron din siyang bisagra or hinge. Tapos dito may handle, which I would presume ay itong buo nabubuksan. Dahil kung titignan natin yung doon sa taas na plan, meron din ditong hinges. Okay? Meron din ditong hinges. So ang isang dapat natin gawin dito, ito, kailangan mo na-emphasize yung thickness. Ito, yung thickness na. Kailangan natin itong i-emphasize din. Or medyo may gap siya. Medyo may gap. So, well, ok okay na yan, ganyan, no problem naman. Later on, i-rotate lang natin siguro ng konto, no? Dito natin siya ipapivot sa hinge. Okay, lahat ito kasi pwede natin i-reposition. Pwede natin yan na i-re-ano. Kunwari, nakabukas pa rin ang campus. Although, pag nakabukas kasi, kailangan model natin yung loob na meron nakikita ang loob. Okay. Hindi nga natin po alam kung ano yung loob. So, ano lang natin for the meantime, nandito pa tayo nanonood ng premiere. And then nilabas ko na parang tapos na yata yung premiere. Tapos din may babe slaps pa po tayo nakabantay, binabantayan po natin yung babe slaps dahil yung mga iba natin kasamahan. Pag nagla-live sila, maraming mga pumapasok. Wala sa akin. Isang pinaka-delikado is na na-screen capture yung mga gumagamit ng hindi maayos na profile. So, anyway, teka. Listen po muna to it. Monitor po muna si Dave. Ayun po. So, ito pwede natin ilagay yun dun. Slide number 2. Natin itong parang hatch, hindi naman naka-curve, no? Hindi siya naka-tunog siya curve, nitong ano, hindi siya makasunod, parang plot lang siya, no? Parang naka-plot siya. So, mas madali yun. Tapos, meron lang dito yung ano kaya to, split. Split siguro to, silipan. Parang slit, butas, silipan. Dito meron pa tayong butas din, ano ha? Parang gun port yata ito eh, gun port. Or ano ba yan? Meron kasing parang pistol. Diyan pwedeng ilabas yung handgun. No? Diyan sa lugar na yung tinagong parang picture. Pistol port parang butas para pwedeng ilabas doon yung pistola. Yun ang araw, ano pa yan, pistol pa siya na close in ang pipe. Yung tabaw na yun, ano pa. So anyway, saka na natin ilagay yan kasi maglalagay tayo ng panibagong mix dito, sabihin. Ito naman, may butas din dito, no? So, ito pwede natin ilagay. Itong butas, pwede na yan, ano? Sa materials na lang. Okay? Sa materials na lang natin yung doon. Hindi na tayo masyadong nilang. Alright, and mag-aano naman tayong mix dyan, magugulo. So anyway, dito, so tignan natin sa front, no? Ayan. So ito, lalabas, square lang halos, no? Flat surface. Okay. So sige, start. Start natin. So dito, kailangan natin dyan. Add ng mesh, plane lang yun, plane. Patayuin natin sa x-axis. Tip natin sila. Tip po natin. Ayan. Magtama lang sana kami. Ang kaya tayo makaano. Ginalaw natin ito eh. Hindi na natin na solo eh. Hindi, too much yung ano eh, top tsaka bottom eh. Ah, yung front eh. Compromise natin konti. Can't be home now. Can't go home now. You won't get it. Maybe a party. And in a hurry, guess you're not around. When you look wonderful tonight. Oh my darling, you're wonderful tonight. Support na yan dyan dahil mo wala na kumain na yan dali gagawa natin ang paraan yan dito ito rin kung ano na wala na recommendation yan na sa ano, pero ano yun, tanghalian pa pa lang yun. Dahil, hindi ako na ba yun. Okay, so. Okay, so wait lang. Sorry po. Naka-curve siguro konting-konti na ha. Ibig sabihin, naka-curve to. Dali lang. Delete natin ito. Kung naka-curve yan, nakasabay dito. Dito tayo kukuha ng ano. Dito tayo kukuha ng tawag dito. Dito tayo kukuha ng plane. Dito tayo kukuha para isasabay natin sa curve. Pero ito, straight ito. Malamang straight. Pero itong ano, surface na ito, maka-curve ito. Sa sled at ng time Doren pointed so scale natin ito sa Z it's under or pinapindot yung Z scale sa Z 0 sa'yo. Oo, oh, sa'yo po. Oops. Mali tayo ng ano dyan. Sobra. Mali yung paghahal at halpak natin. Thank you. ano na po tayo dun sa ganyan. Sabi ko nga po, hindi tayo speed modeling, ano? Hindi po tayo tuloy-tuloy. Ito kasi po, parang documentation lang aking. Hindi naman po talaga ito. Ito yung personal project ko. Kung makagawa ko ng mga ganitong 3D model, hindi ko naman po talaga trabaho mag-model ng mga CG. Nag-retire lang po tayo at itong pinagkakabalahan ko ng oras. Dahil matagal ko ng interesting gawin. Siguro ever since na matuto ko sa computer, tingnan ako na ng 3D kung paano ginagawa. Wala pa yung Windows 95. Kaya lang, dahil nga wala pa noon ang mga technology masyado. Infancy pa. Napakahirap maghanap ng software dito sa atin. Wala ng software available. Tapos wala rin mga ano. Kaya nahuhuli tayo. Nahuli. Then, matagal na panahon, hindi ko naman ngayon pinansin dahil hindi ko ngayon trabaho eh. Kaya lang, ngayon, libre na po tayo. So, nilalagyan natin ng time. Ayaw na naman ito. Dali lang, speaker ko po ang lolo ko. Lumang-luma na po ito kasing tanda ko na rin ito. Pihit bago mo mapatunod. Kaya napalitan mo yun. Kaya lang, maganda tunog nito. Wala ka lang. Yung sinaunang mga speaker kasi, magagandang klase. Yung mga speaker ngayon, parang masyadong mahina. Ito, ang liit-liit nito pero ang lakas. Very powerful. Yung mga speaker na magnet, yung material, titibay, lumaluma na. Yung lang ang problema, yung knob, maluwag na. Saka itong jack, hindi na dahil sakto, no, ha? Sila eh. And buting ka ng siyam-siyam, gano'n lang. Yun, mag-grounded na. Yun, hindi siya dumidikit mabuti. Minsan kasi itong mga plug na. Yun, okay. Minsan, isang saksak lang, okay, minsan. Ang beses mo na pinipilit, ayaw. Ano talaga? Yun. Yun. Okay, pa naman. Lakas. Sobra. Na yung knob niya maluwag. Yun. Mahina. Okay, good. So, tapos na yung bagong obligasyon. So, dito na tayo. Okay? This is set up pa lang to. Then later, Kaya mag-break po tayo dahil marami po tayong activity ginawa ng araw nito. Marami po tayong activity ginawa kanina. Tulad na nandun po tayo sa yung sinabi ko nga sa tawag dito. Nandun tayo sa panangmanay ko kanina kay Milano, which is nag-live kami doon. Anyway, doon sa kabilang ano yun, kabilang channel, doon ang Rino. Ito po kasi yung John Rino po. Okay. So, inano ko lang po yung watch hour nito. Just in case kasi na maano yung channel na at least may reserve na. Wala naman itong ano, hindi ito ang may channel. Si Mang Rui na po yung may channel. Yan lang, kaya hindi naman. Pero ganun din eh. Sabi ko dapat kung ano ko kasi yung account nito. So anyway, never mind. So patay, isa pa. Daming channel yun. Diyan nga lang, hirap na hirap ka eh. So, anyway, tuloy natin to, no? Tapos mamaya, kakain po tayo. Dahil, late yung tanghalian ko kanina. So, maghahapunan po tayo, late din. Hindi rin kagad tayo makakatulog dahil kakain lang natin. Tapos ito. Sandali lang tumas yung watch hour ko late. Sunod-sunod na. Live. Bilis eh. Kaya ito. So tingin ko. Tingin 4 months to 5 months. Tapos yung 4,000 ito. Wala pong video ito. Dagawin piraso. Dadagdagan po natin later. Nilalive po nung nilalive yung aking project. Dahil ito yung mga gagamitin din naman sa mga videos. Sariling asset po yung ating mga video. Hindi tayo nakikikopya sa iba. Or may mga kung anong iba, kahuyin lang ng kahuyin, buuin, hindi po. Hindi po natin yun na, hindi ko po yun dahil gusto ko nga makakreate. Nung ako'y akin naman, although gagamitin natin sila bilang mga inspirasyon yung ibang mga talagang tunay na 3D artist, no? Dahil hindi po tayo 3D artist. Tayo ay nag-aaral. So, oops, okay. Ito gagawin natin. Teka lang sandali ha. Kasi wala na nang tayong tamang direksyon. Saan papunta yung ating ano. Dapat yung kanina na-preserve ko yun ano. Kasi kung saan yung ano nito. Saan ang punta nito. Anong direction po nito, naka-angle po tayo. So, gagawa lang ako nung ano, gagawa lang ako ng plane para lang sa direction ng ating mga axis. Dahil ito, malabo po ito. Okay, so, add lang tayo dito, temporary. Add tayo ng plane. Yan, tayo natin sa x-axis. Tapos isunod natin dito. Rotate natin dito sa x. Sunod natin to dito. Sunod natin. Okay, yan. Halos ganun. Tapos kukunin natin yung plane niyan. Okay? Yung mukha niya. Ito, tapos na ito. Nagamit na natin yan. plus tayo, plane. So, ibig sabihin, ito yung magiging basihan ng ating axis. Para pag may hinila tayo, Z, X, Y, Z, tulad nito. Diyan na ngayon yan, pag nilagay natin sa plane, diyan na siya makasunod. Ganun. Okay. So, maganda. Okay. Nandiyan na yung ating one. Okay. Wala naman yan. Itago lang natin yung ano na yan. Kahit tanggalin nga natin yan dahil nandito na sa ating tawag dito. Dito. Dito sa ating transform na nakuha na natin yung mukha nito. So anyway, i-disappear ko na lang siya, no? Para hindi na siya store mo. So yan na ngayon yun, right? So every time na mag-edit tayo at naka-angle na po kasi yan, ano siya, no? Magtatama yung ating axis, perpendicular sa mga axis. Okay. Talagang akala mo, kailangan pa talaga ng perpendicular, mamanufacture, ano ha? Hindi naman po natin mamanufacture yan. Kaya lang, mas mabuti niya yung ganun. Kaya tulad nito. Kasi tatambi niya yan eh, pag hinaltak natin nung wala sa tamang axis. O, di hindi siya ngayon tambi niya, no? Simple na yan, ganyan po. Okay, good. So anyway, may nakabidji no ha. Maraming salamat din po sa nakabidji. Hindi na magpapakilala kung sino. Ayan. Pero maraming salamat. Okay. O baka nga. So, anyway, ganyan lang yung kanina pa natin pinilagay. Yun lang yung gagawin kanina pa. Eh, kasi po meron po tayong ibang pinaglalahanan din ng atensyon na baka maulit yung mga hindi kasi maiwasan po yung YouTube yung mga makukulit sa chat box. Eh, napapahamak yung may-ari ng channel. Lalo na yung mga hindi yung mga gumagamit ng mga profile picture na hindi kaaya-aya kasi lalabas dito sa screen yun eh. Hindi agad na hide, hindi agad na alis, madadali yung channel sa section nudity sa palsy. So disgrace SNN. Tama. Ito, hinge natin, pare-parehas yan. So, gagayahin lang natin nandito. Okay? Duplicate lang po natin. Duplicate. Grab. Dalhin lang natin po yan dyan. Didikit po natin dyan. Okay? So, aalisin natin na ito naka-scale pa eh. Object, hindi pa pala na-clear ang scale nito. No? Pwede na natin i-clear yan. Scale 1, palitin sana. Yung rotation, alisin din natin. Pwede natin, alisin natin yung mga rotation nila. Hindi pa rin natin natin. Okay, i-rotate natin siya ng dapat ng rotation. So, mayroong makapal na lugar, saka may standard yan. Dahil yung kapal ng bahay, hindi naka-flash. Naka-ugat lang lang. So, okay. Tinaan mo na. Tanggalin natin itong one hit. Okay, sample pang time. Oops. Ayun na. Uy. Baka ano pala sa rito sa ganito na. Anyway, diba? I-rotate na lang natin din. Ayos. Tapos, dito tayo sa shed. Siguro. Pagsisip tayo tayong rotate loop si Gato na yun. Kailangan yun ang ano, no? Pag wala na tayo sa alignment, right? Pahigayin muna natin konti, ah. Tanda mo na siya sa X and Y axis of symmetry. Okay. Tapos, ano natin sa Z by 14? Dahil dito siya sa nabili pong maliktad. Ganyan. Yeah. Okay. Ganyan siya. Okay. Sumobra tayo sa Z. 90 lang. Okay. 90 factor. Then, sa X, dagdagan natin yung factor. Sorry. Wala na siya sa X. Hindi. Ayaw maganda yan. Ayan. Baka nasan ang X and Y axis na? Ah, wala tayo sa global, no? Nandito nga pala tayo sa plane. Sorry. Okay, hindi pa tayo pala malis dito sa plane. Pwede tayo bumalik muna sa global. Okay, so sa X axis natin, tuloy lang na. Oops. Sabihin na nagalaw na yung local nito. Ano na natin yung local. So, apply na lang natin. Apply na lang natin para hindi tayo may nakon. Apply na lang natin ang kanyang rotation. Para reset. At rotate natin sa X. Doon siya. Hindi dito. Okay. Okay. Individual things. The tape, the edge, yan. Okay. Ganyan. Grab natin ito. Para dito natin, dito siya na talaga. Rotate pa natin konti. Yan. Okay, good. Centro natin. Dito siya. Uy, malaki pala ito, no? Maliit lang ito. Bakit magkaiba sila ng size? Magkaiba pa ng size, no? Malaki ito ng dirito, kaysa dito. Okay, sige. Ipalitin natin. No problem. Scale natin. Lahat ng axis. So, something like this. Okay, good. Align ka ng konti dito. Dito. Yan. Okay, ditong gitna natin. Okay, let me check. Yan. Very good. Very nice. Okay. Actually, madali lang yan. Kung tuloy-tuloy akong nagagawa. Yan. Masyadong attention na pinag-iintindi. Sandali-sandali lang sana yan. Kaya lang, alam mong problema yun. Eh, hindi nga tayo nagmamadali. Dahil, yun na, minsan na natin. Hindi po tayo magagawa. Halitan po natin yung, oops, hindi natin nakikita yung ginagawa natin. Dahil, pagdita na kami, hindi po tayo nag-double. So, ito, lagyan na natin yung edge dito, or new folding. Bakit nagkaroon siya dito ng shading error? Mayroon tayong nahilang mali, no? Hindi, tignan mo. Andun, mayroon tayong shading error dito na hila. Let me see. Wala naman, ano ha? So, bakit mo iba dyan na ano? May shading error. Okay, yun. Wala naman yung diferensya. Sa curve din. Nag-curve din, ha? Bale. So, face orientation na isa nito. And, naka-global pala tayo, no? Pag-ibig, eh. Naka-inset ako, eh. Okay, inset. Tapos, inset pa ulit. Problema kung ating reset na bakit flat yan, hindi sumabay yun sa curve. Ano pa? Ang daming nakaharang. Undo natin yung huling inset. At, naka-bevel na pala eh. Kaya pala. Okay. Sorry. Lagyan natin ang generate lang natin yung subdivision surface. Yan. Yan. Lagyan natin isang loop dito para medyo ma-hold yung loop dito. Ibig sabihin, meron tayong face sa loob, no? Nasa ilalim. Okay, o yun, meron na. Well, pwede, pwede pabayan na natin yun. Bakit? Para pag ginalaw natin ito, inangat, may meron siyang thickness. Malay mo, i-display natin itong makaangat itong ano. Ito. Ano lang siya. Okay. So anyway. Ganyan lang. Nice na. Right? Sa oras na tayo. Yung talagang paggawa, 5 minuto lang. Sorry po. Makinig-kinig lang pong music. Okay, so lalagyan natin handle. Dito, di ba? May handle yan. Tignan natin yung picture. Yan. Yan lang po yun eh. Right? Yan. Ito, di ba? Hinge. Tapos yan. Tignan natin. Yan. O, lagyan natin ng ano. Ganyan. Kulay. Yan. Parehas. Yan yung takato. Ang kaibahan lang nito sa atin. Kinerve ko, no? Kinerve. Ito kasi. Sa tingin ko to, ito, flat. Yan, pag nilagay ko yung flat, parang pangit eh. Pero dito, nagkaroon tayo ng counting, parang tawag dito, artist freedom. Artist na interpretation. Kasi, hindi din, wala naman din talaga to, hindi na ito original. Hindi ko sabihin, captured mga gamit yan at maaaring mga may replacement parts na ng mga ginawa dyan and so on so. So hindi naman talaga na yun. Which I would think na napaka ano ng attention ng detail ng sa phone. And I doubt very much kung mamiss nila. Okay, so ito to gawa na tayo handle na to. Sandaling-sandali lang yan, wala pang ilang yun. Kung hindi ka nagdadal-dal, no ha? So, add lang tayo ulit ng ano kaya dyan? Sige, simple lang. Plain ulit. Okay. Plain ulit. Tapos, edit natin to. Object. Edit mode. Okay. Lahat ng vertex, lagay natin sa iluwa muna natin pang to. Grab tubal na. Sige, hindi natin yung makikita. Tapos si ano lang natin, merge sa sentro. So tuldok na lang yun to. So isang tuldok na. So yung tuldok na yan, yan na ngayon yung gagawin natin. Ilagay natin dito. Ayan, dito ba? Ilagay natin dyan yung tuldok na yan. Yung tuldok na yan ay bitig na natin distas kung nasaan siya. Hindi na natin ma-distinguish, no? Kung sa mga drawing or what. Malabo niya. Na nga, hindi naman ano itong reproduction itong ating tinitignan plano. Ito original na original. So, dito lang. Ito, pwede na ito. Okay, i-in natin. Gawa tayong itong control right click tayo ulit, control right click tayo ulit, yan, okay. Medyo lang tibigus naman natin, so ganyan lang, no? Right, okay, gusto mo straighten pa natin yan, walang problema, no? Scale natin yan sa y axis, 0, okay, gusto mong distorin, pantay na pantay, walang problema rin yan, scale natin yung z, 0, okay, pantay na pantay, ganun din ito, scale to z, 0, right, naka-align pa tayo sa x and y axis, diba, tayong tayo yan, okay, nakatayo pa tayo, so, no problem yan, so, ganyan lang, yan lang yan, okay, yan lang yan, and then, balik tayo sa object mode, Ito, dahil selected pa siya, i-convert natin sa curve. Okay, so nakakurve na po ngayon yan. Ibig sabihin, curve object. No, iba kasi ang characteristic ng curve object. Para ma-manipulate natin. So dito sa ating property panel, itong data ng ating curve, ito yung ating i-click. Ito yung data ng curve na yan. So dito sa kanyang geometry, i-open natin yan. Tapos, ayan, select natin yung kanyang bevel. So rounded, round lang. Tapos depth, lagyan natin ng depth, no? Yung kapal. Ayan, laki na nga yun. Lit lang. Okay. Ayan, ba't nagkaganyan? Hindi pantay yung ano, paiko. Ang problem niyan, yung scale hindi na-set. Okay? Apply natin yung ating scale. Yung scale ng ating properties, wala siguro sa 1. The object, apply, scale. Okay. Apply, rotation. Sigurado lang ba? Naka-apply naman, naka-0 na. Okay. Okay, so balik tayo sa curve. Curve. Okay, so it's supposed to be ano lang siya, ng pantay, pre-preo. So, medyo ayaw talaga siya, ano. Bakit? Eh, malaki dito kaysa doon. Dito nag-ano siya, nag-bevel na. Resolution, lagi lang natin sa 2. Kapalan pa natin ng konti. Ayan. Yung problema natin. Okay. Log Fairby, wish it wasn't portrait mode can see the whole screen. Yeah. I should see the landscape, but that is not the idea. I'm not after the one. This is not a tutorial anyway. I am just documenting how I did it and the views, and what I am gunning for this time is just to gain a bit of watch hour. So we are not doing any speed modeling and so on. So I'm sorry about that, love, beyond. Okay, so sometimes you cannot see the whole screen. There are a lot of good tutorials because I don't know also this one. I'm still learning. That's why I'm not attempting to. But maybe you learn wrong things from me because I'm just studying also the Blender. I'm not so familiar with this. That's why, for example, this, I don't know the reason why is this crooked. Look, this different. Here, the radius is big than here, right? That's a problem. I don't know what caused it. Does it be like that, really? Or we can do something about that? I don't know also. So, just bear with me. So anyway, there are a lot of obstruction, huh? Because we still have all our turrets and everything else. Let's remove muna. Because I cannot locate it and I can see clearly that is helping. So anyway, we can also maybe reduce this just manually, right? Maybe we just use the radius here, and maybe we just make it look smaller so it looks straight like that. Actually, the length here is not, not the same. We can scale that maybe. I don't know if I can scale this to the Z axis. Nothing. So we just move it here. Grab it to see. Because this is now a curve. So anyway. Okay, hope you are having a good day. I'm a beginner belt blender starting learning. Oh yes, you're a beginner also. The mistake I did when I was learning this. I'm just very new in this blender also, very new. And I'm not a graphic artist. That is not my job long time ago. However, when I was learning it, my mistake was where do you want to use the model? Because before, for example, this is a hard surface modeling. When I was trying to learn it, I tried doing all those example also. I'm just learning it here in YouTube. And when I choose something to learn from, I didn't know that the intent of the video was a product modeling. So it's highly detailed and so on so. Because it's different when you are just going to use it, let's say for a video, just a representation. So the detail is not that much really. So I spent too much time detailing because I don't have intention of doing product representation like the ones they use in advertisements, and it has to be exactly the same. I said, I just want to have like this, you know, for example, this Hago model, this for just ordinary video and something like that. So I don't really, you know, before I spent too much time just for the details, which was a bit wrong. So you have to learn or study where are you go. You have to take that also into consideration when you are trying to learn from others. Is this for product modeling? Okay, I want to do all these details, how they do this and do that. But it doesn't apply to all the models. For example, this handle. It should not be so much detail in this. So anyway, I like this this curve. So actually, I approach it wrong, no? Because this now is not rounded. It's supposed to be rounded, so now it's not rounded. So let me see what happens if we convert this again to we convert this again to mesh. Okay. So now it's totally like this. Mali. No, look, the radius here is terrible. No, okay, it's wrong. So anyway, never mind. This is not straight like this one. Sometimes the curve is not so not reliable. The scale is too wide to make it a little bit of adjustment. Yeah, like that. Okay. This look better. And now I have a problem with here. This the bevel is gone. We should bevel this. So let me just say if I can fix this, like Alt-B. Yeah. Okay, that's the main segments. Just a few. But now they are all crazy, right? So that's what I'm saying. Now they're all crazy. Okay. If I approach this different way, like for example, because I approach one single before. If I use the different way method, I'll just keep this one, okay? I'll duplicate this, duplicate that one. Oops, sorry. We approach it different way. So duplicate and P selection. So now we have a duplicate. Okay. And we just remove this thing. I'm not happy. This is crazy. Is there X? Dissolve all this. Or just remove this object. Okay. Or we can use it as a guide. Never mind. So I will just keep that other one. Object, where is that? That small object before. Where is that? This one. Maybe there in the other side. Okay. Now this is a different object, right? From this also. So what we can do, which is a lot better, and this is better, is just extrude this vertically. Okay. So edit mode, again tap hold, and then extrude E to Z, and like that. Okay, once we go here, once we are here, you just select maybe one of the here, okay, and then Shift S the cursor to select that, okay, and then you go to view here on the side and move the cursor, this one, a little bit farther out, maybe around here. That will be the radius of the curve. No, you'll just estimate the radius of the curve. So you move this out. So we move this Y. We keep the X and Y position of the cursor, right? Like this. You have to have the corner. Yeah. It's terrible. Wait, what's what happened to my wife? Global. The location. Okay. Where's my my goodness. So now I'm also in trouble now. Where is my cursor now? Yeah, there you are. We're just going to, why it doesn't move to the Y location? Oh, it moves to the X, sorry. Let's be in the X. Oops. Now I have undid everything. My goodness. Okay, let's do this again. We just we approach this in the same problem, like doing a pipe. I should have done it that way. Extrude the same. Yeah, oops. Grab the same. Straight. Like that. And then just select one of this edge here. Torso selected. Okay. Then it should be the X. I should have moved the X away from there. A little bit. Just tiny bit. Oops. Ooh. Now the problem is it won't run really, huh? So we type the ano? Kasi it's jumping. Maybe we reduce this by 2.5. Oops, that's too far out. Where did it go? Point 315. If I increase this, go up. Okay. Just remove the here. Ooh, that's too far. So it's very, very optional. See? Let's move. One. Two. Yeah, there. That is about somewhere there. Or maybe just half more. Oops, that's too much. So 0.5, maybe a 2. Yeah, something like that. And this, we use this for this spin. We use the spin. Okay. Sorry. So we use this spin function. This one here. Okay, this spin. Okay. I will move this a little bit here so we can see them together. So now you spin in the Z axis. So we change the axis of the spin. You can see it from here on top. So we spin this in the Y axis like that. Okay. So we select all this again, our vertices here. On top, we select all these vertices. Okay, we select them all like that. Ayan, there is all selected. I just checked whether it's all selected. And then we just pull this there like that. You can just pull it like this. So it will be a perfectly rounded corner. And of course, we reduce the steps. That's too much. That's a lot. The 12, maybe we can just use this a little bit. Maybe 4 is enough, like that. And of course, the spin, we make it 90 degrees. So it's perfectly perpendicular. Yeah, that's better. You see? Yeah. And then we can this one, this end here, we can get out of our spin and we can extrude this again to the X direction. We can extrude this and bring it somewhere here, there, and we can do the same again. Or better still, we just go this some okay, we just cut this here in the middle. Okay, I remove this. Oops, sorry. X, just dissolve these vertices. We don't need them anymore. And also this object, I don't need this anymore. We just remove this, delete now. So we need this one. And what else? We just mirror it. So we have the perfect on the other side. So here, we're just going to generate again. We just in our properties. We use this wrench here and then add the modifier. We just generate the mirror. Okay. But before we do that, maybe I need to change the origin of our object. So I will use this as our origin. So we select this cursor. We put the cursor here. And then here in our properties in top. I will show again here. We just go out to object mode and here the object, we just say set origin to the 3D cursor. We just move that cursor here, right? It will be aligned on this circle here. So, or the middle of that circle. Set the origin to the 3D cursor. So there, that is our origin. Once we then we add the mirror, generate the mirror, because the mirror will always start from the origin. Okay, so that is a better approach. That's a very perfect way of doing curves. The first thing that I did kanina, I thought you know, by just modifying it, curves and so on, so I thought it would function like this, but this is, I think, the only best approach. So here we have a very perfect handle. The thing that they always do here, the secret of this, I just found out myself, is here the radius of this, right? depends on how far, this is the radius. So you just estimate how far you're going to put the cursor, this one. Like kanina, the moment ago, I just choose this point here as a reference. I just use this point here as reference, so that I move it aligned without moving from let's say the Y and the Z axis. I just move it from one axis, from the X, a little bit farther out to have this good radius here, and then use the spin here. Use the spin to just spin it. Select how many segments you're going to do, and that's it. Yeah, you just use the spin function. This very, very quick and very nice. It will be a very perfect curve. Look, it will be a perfect curve. Any pipe that you do, it's like this. We can also make a tight corner here. If this cursor is just right here, like for example, I just put it somewhere here, this will be very tight because the radius is small. The distance here controls your radius. So it will be a very tight corner. Yeah, I don't want a tight corner. That's why I put it a bit farther out. Then spin this one. You just select them all and spin like that. You can change the axis of the spin here, X, Y, Z, and the steps also. Okay, I think that's I thank you if you learned something. But that's one of the basic tools you can do here to make a 3D model. Okay, very nice. Thank you for visiting my channel, LogDRB. From where are you? Because I'm trying to speak English, that is not my native language. Any kind of curved pipes and so on, so you can also control the spin, what angle you just want. Here we need it perfect 90 degrees, so you know, in the spin you just control the angle. Okay, thank you very much for dropping by. So here we have a handle already, and we just need to add this to our tank. Okay, and I think where is our tank now? Where is my high shape? I think here somewhere. Okay, there. So we have this, to position this now somewhere here. Okay, so maybe I need to go back to the object mode and just put it here. Okay, and maybe I need to sometimes, like for example, we want to rotate this, our transform. This is a very, very important cursor. Before, when I was trying to learn Blender, I didn't know how to use the cursor properly. I thought it's just, you know, cursor something where, but actually this has a big influence on how you're going to move things. For example, like this is supposed to be perpendicular right here, right? We are going to move this this way, and to move it this way, it's better if we pivot from the base. We don't pivot anywhere else. We can pivot here, but it doesn't look natural pivoting that way. So I just go and edit mode and just go here, select all this bottom, and then shift again the cursor to the selected here, and then just change again the object's origin to 3D cursor. So we will move from here, okay, and select here from, or you cannot, even though we can, we don't really need to change the origin also, okay, we just need the ano, we can keep the origin there, we just need the cursor here, and here we just select transform from cursor. So when we press R and rotate, it will rotate from there, and it's easier to estimate where it looks nice. It's easier to do it that way. Again, I move the other one. I just want to move my object closer to the there. Okay. Change the origin wood, yeah, minor, until you apply. Change the origin wood. Wait. Sorry, I cannot read because there is a heart. Would mess up the mirror, right, until you apply it. Yes, it would mess the mirror. So until we apply this, it will change, it will if we keep the origin as long as it's in the center line, because when I choose it, look, edit mode. When I choose this one, for example, and it will go here, then this go here, then the mirror will be from here na. It will be wrong. And we haven't applied for the mirror yet. That's right. You are right there. So we just move the cursor to move where the transformation will start or done. So that's it. Okay, then maybe I need to push for this a little bit inward, because this tank, this is Japanese tank, is a bit challenging because there is no symmetry. They didn't build it symmetrical. So you have to model the left and the right. Oops, sorry, I'm in the on the object monitor. Then I have to model the left and the right. It's crazy. The tank looks good so far. Yeah. It's a Hago tank. It's a Japanese tank. And it's very challenging, that's why I use it. I said I will use it for practice, because it has no symmetry. it is not symmetrical. You know, you are the first viewer I have that understand 3D. I'm very happy. I don't have really a viewer that doesn't that understand 3D, and you are the first one. Yeah, and the first one that I exchange. Sometimes I'm just talk to myself. Okay, then okay there. However, as I've said, I don't really do speed modeling. I'm just taking this leisurely. So there are others, although it's very difficult to understand sometimes the other tutorial, because they're doing it very fast, and the intent of the tutorial, you don't, sometimes the intent is different from what you need. And it's very difficult to find tutorials that are specific to what you need. Oh, YouTube suggested your stream, so I don't. Must be because I search Blender tutorials in my algorithm. Oh yeah. Thank you. But I'm still doubting myself if I can do tutorials. Maybe for beginners just like me. Because if I look at those other professional and expert, you know, they really are good. For basic shapes and, you know, I've been doing this a lot already. So I'm a little bit in the intermediate level. I can make just something like that. I have started asking ChatGPT to explain things to me and help and learn much faster. Oh, that's a good idea also. Before, when I learned it about 3 years ago, you don't have ChatGPT, you know, I just learned from YouTube. I learned from hundreds of YouTube. Sometimes you just need one press button. You want to solve one. How do I do this? Just one press of a button will the problem disappear. It's very difficult to know. I understand how difficult it is. If you don't have a tutor, personal tutor, or you don't learn from, if you learn only by yourself. I get stuck, I ask, and it usually helps me understand. It's way faster than asking on forums. Yes, maybe so, yeah. Because they already collate all the good answers. Sometimes in forums, when you check on forums, it's very difficult to understand also. It's shortened the explanation. It seems that they understand each other, and they are only the ones that can understand themselves. Anyway, of course, yeah, it was very annoying for me. I learned basic modeling and so on, so maybe in 3 months. But I've been doing this for at least 3 years now. But I haven't moved on so much because it's just once in a while and sometimes. I'm trying to move from hard modeling to organic, like characters and so on. So, but I get stuck in the mga riggings and the topology and things like that. So, I went back again to my hard. I have one other channel, which is Mang Wino. All my other works are there. This is John Wino. If you find another Wino, that is also my other channel. That is organic modeling, like characters and things like that. Unfortunately, last November, my hard drive conked out. It died on me, and a lot of my work there is gone. So I have to redo everything. So anyway, so now we just smooth this, okay? And that would be just the basic thing to do. That's it. Anyway, I'll just put a basic color for a while, just temporarily to make it nice. Of course, we have to apply pad real materials for this. UV, we haven't done pa. We haven't done UV pa of this, and the object of this material is there is no symmetry. If you look at the front, there is no symmetry here. You have to look, everything is off center. So it's a bit of a challenge. If there is a symmetry, then it will have been very quick. Whereas now, you have to do it individually. So anyway, look at this. Look at this mud gun. It's not the same. It's not the same. Yeah, characters are hard to model in plants. I'm got stuck in plants, doing the plants, I got stuck. And that's the problem. Not really a problem. I did a few plants already. But to make it like, for example, optimize, when you have don't have too many practices, that's the I'm trying to learn now you Unreal Engine 5. So the environment, I said, I think I can do the environment in the Unreal Engine, but the modeling is here in Blender. You just combine the modeling, the Unreal Engine, and the Blender. That would be very, very powerful. So, well, it's good now. Okay, now we have this, okay. The rivets, we will just do it later. It's the end, no? The end. We just stick it. We use also arrays and also modifier, wherein you just use the modifier here to put it in the skin. We will just use later. That would be very easy in the shrink wrap. We'll just use this. It will wrap. It will just stick into the here the magnet. It's very easy to align all those bits with your. I will do it all at the same time. But anyway, that's it. Now we have another hinge here, on top two hinges here. Let's say I will check on my plan. References, okay. MP, don't need that, you don't need that. So here there are another two hinges. It will be the same this one, so I'll just copy this, put it here. This one hole, this one. Which they are better, they're all the same anyway. So just duplicate it. I will just duplicate it. And move. Oops, why it didn't go? Okay, did I duplicate it? Or maybe I prefer duplicate. Grab. Okay, why there was a lag because we are in the render mode. We go back here, okay? The computer was lagging because it's in the render mode, of course. So, I will just move this. I save also, maybe it will crash. And there. Oh, I have a magnet on, that's why. I have the magnet on. I was not able to. So here, because I already applied the rotation, that's why sometimes when you apply the rotation early, then of course, you have to estimate the properties na lang later. This is another okay. So we just remove all these properties here to make it end. Where it is actually. Just if I make them and maybe I'll just rotate it from again from the individual origins. And I'll rotate it in the X to make it a little bit straight. Like it, okay. And then I just remove the reference to blocking maybe. Rotate it 90 degrees. Okay, here from the Z. Like that. Okay, maybe a little bit Y with the X. Somewhere like this here, okay. And we'll bring it down. We are going to fix this also, I think. Why? From the picture, it's overlapped. It's not flush. It's not flush. So I don't have the good reference. You need the other side. Here. And here it's not clear now whether there is an for sure this not a straight. Okay. Maybe this is a little bit up. Or I don't know. Yes, we cannot distinguish na from the plan. Looks like a weld. I don't think it's a weld because they put hinges here. So if you look at the reference, there is a hinge. So this can be lifted. You know, this can be lifted, and it will pivot here in this hinge. So this must have a separate, this is a separate object, this thing here, this one. Maybe it's a hatch, and then it has a small port, this one here. So, yeah, because there is a hinge. Are you going to use PBR texture to make it realistic? Maybe I will just use a painting, no? I will just use a texture painting. We just use texture painting, so we can paint dust, we can paint things like that. Sometimes it's difficult to another PBR to use if the UV, special UV. Sometimes difficult to map the UV for the UBR, for the PBR. And I just do the UV simple, then paint something like rust, scratches, and things like that. You just paint it in. They use the substance painter. I don't have a substance painter. I just use Krita. It's good enough for my purpose. Here again, I will duplicate this and move it to the other side. Okay. There we go. But I think the hinge is big enough. It's a little bit bigger. Yeah. Top. Yeah, it's big. And maybe we need to scale this down. Oh, sorry if I'm moving it rapidly. There we go. How to bake it to individual PBR texture pan. Hard to bake it, yeah. I tried using procedural textures and texture painting, but Unity didn't work nicely. Oh, I see. Okay. Hard to bake it to individual PBR texture pan. Yeah, that's the one that I also trying to learn, and bake the textures. How to bake textures, how to find. I have not tried that more. It's just, some experiment, not really done it right. I'm just trying to learn it one by one, something like that. And I haven't come up something that would suit my may music sa The Cloud, wait lang. Okay. So, I'm trying to figure that out also. I think I will be in the same manner with you there. Texturing again is also very, very challenging thing. That's why it's called their expertise. There are different experts in texturing, different experts in modeling, materials, creating material. I really wonder how did they create those materials. So anyway, because I don't have any graphics artist background. No, my job when I was still on, I'm an old guy. Yeah, I'm very old. I'm retired already. I'm just doing this, you know, personal project. Keep myself busy. Keep my mind tuned. So, I'm not that young, you know. Hello? So, I'm not trying to learn this to get a job or things like that. So, I'm just doing it on my own, you know, on time, and don't pressure myself too much. So, I really want to do this, learn this, because when I was still young, I really am interested in this. It's good, huh? It's a bit strange that I appeared in your recommendation. Because I don't have that much video. You see, this is my live. If you check the live stream in my channel, this is the first project I did for this channel. This is the first project. This is the 17th Siesta. Yeah, and guys who program shades, I had no idea how to write a shader. Yeah, those nodes thing. My goodness, I said, how did they learn that? But sometimes the more you use it, and the more you can actually visualize and understand all the functions. After a while, you'll be able to make your own shader. Those two easy ones, but those complicated ones. The one that I'm trying to learn now is the geometry nodes. I haven't started yet. How did they? Because I don't know. Maybe I'll use ChatGPT also. That's a good idea. How did they know that this certain function like that, right? Because there's a lot of things there to choose from. And how did they know that when you connect this to this and this, this will result to this? That's really, you know. But sometimes, of course, also in materials, when you do a lot already, you will be able to visualize what's going on. I don't know anything about geometry nodes. Yeah, I haven't started yet about geometry nodes. That's one of my targets later. I said how to do that, especially in the organic modeling for plants and things like that. Sometimes they do the effects. There are a lot of good. I've been following. Sometimes I don't want to offend others, but it's. It's just very difficult on my side, because English is not my native language. So learning from YouTube, sometimes the accent, different accent, is very difficult. So I have to slow down the video. I cannot understand what they're saying. And I learned a lot more European YouTubers from Europe, like George, what's his name again? Julifjord, I use him. But if you want to do detailed 3D modeling for, let's say, planes and things like that, he has a very small YouTube. I follow his technique also. What's his name again? I think it was Mark something. I don't know. I will look for it somewhere. Because his technique that he used, although very tedious, is really, the result is amazing. And then now there are a lot of good ones. But at the time when I was studying, I studied from him. So anyway, you speak English pretty well. Thank you. I don't know. It's not my second language. Maybe I got just used to it because now, of course, we have to be know about English. It's gathering information, is everything is in English. So reading and listening from YouTube. Yes, I'm studying in YouTube University. I called it YouTube University. Must be telling that all of UI language and editor is in English too. So you have to learn all the technique. Yes. For example, that's why I didn't learn the 3ds Max before when I was young. I started using 3ds Max version 4 the first time it appeared. I can grab only here in my place, in my country, the version 4 using resourcefulness, of course. Just being resourceful, you understand that. Because you cannot get it at that time, it's still in the year 2000, something like that, 20 years ago. They were just version 3, 3DX Max 4, and something like that. The problem then was there is no YouTube. You only study from the web, and it's all in written form, like a book. Then they have a few pictures, a few pictures that they say, this one, blah, 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 in the text. The problem then was, which are they referring to in the picture or in the text when they say something like, when you move the bevel, blah, blah, blah. I said, what is this part? So that's what you're trying, the technical terms. I had to learn them all pa. That's why in the 3DX Max, for example, bevel, here in Blender, that's why it's easy. Because when you say bevel, it's just bevel. In 3DX Max, you have to bevel when it is different from the inside, they have different terms. When you bevel from the outside, they have different terms. You chamfer, so I said, what's chamfering? So I dropped it long time ago, and now I just returned. My son told me, Dad, if you really want to learn that, you try Blender. I said, okay, wait, I'll look at it. When I look at it, then the UI is very, very easy. I said, oh, this is pretty quick to learn. I tried 3DX Max long time ago, 20 years ago. I never really got past that, no? a few days of study. Because there's no video yet at that time. You have to read it all from text. It's very difficult. And when they wrote it, it seems that they are the only ones trying to understand. They understand each other. especially from magazines. I also have magazines, of 3D magazines, things like that. Of course, they already know what they're talking about, and you are lost at what are they referring to in this picture? What are they referring to? Move this, and so, like, oh my goodness. I said, I cannot do this. So, I shoved it away. He said, okay. He said, at that time, I have a job, and then just doing it in my free time. And the learning curve is very high. The learning curve is very high. So I said, no. I don't have time for this. So, after this, then, now technology is very more advanced than before. So, I'm just, catching up. I'm supposed to be one of those that are first to be interested in 3D. The only thing is I cannot understand what they're talking about. Now, you can see in the video, you see an explanation. It's very easy, very quick. But still, sometimes you get lost. Oh, you get stuck. Oh, what's they going to do next? Right? Okay, now this is just my objective for this session. The hymns here and this one here. So I think it's done this part. And any major thing here in the front side, I will put it in here. It's okay. Actually, before I'm doing this, everything in landscape, ano? In landscape mode of what they call this streaming. However, my object is not about delivering good content. Fine, I'm not at that stage yet. So I'm just documenting what I do and things like that. I don't focus pa on how to create my content. And I just want to finish the required from YouTube, which the watch hour and fun. And using vertical format, they recommend it more than compared to the landscape format. The vertical format appears in shorts, so views are a lot more. You gain a lot more views easier than doing your live stream in landscape, because the recommendation in landscape, you must have a very good thumbnail and title, etc. So I do the vertical thing just to keep it recommended in together with shorts, and sometimes hit a little more views than usual, and that way I earn more watch hour and reach the threshold of the YouTube, the threshold they require for monetization and things like that. Because now I'm not yet monetized. You know, this is a small channel. I don't even have a subscriber. It's the 60 people. So anyway, I don't really mind about content and so on. So they always say, you think of your content. No, I don't believe it. When you are small, we are recommended small. So I am doing the watch hour first, because that is the very difficult to make. Yes, it must work, because you got suggested in your stream. Yeah, I only have 59 subscribers. I said, how come it got recommended? I even wonder, it just occurred to me. How did that become recommended? something like that. So I said, sometimes it's the in the vertical format. So that's my ano, my target for now. For now, it's just to get the views and watch hour. So sometimes because those that will swipe in the shorts, because it goes together with the shorts. Sometimes they stay a little bit longer than usual, or sometimes they swipe it quickly. Sometimes they stay, but then you will still accumulate the watch hour, especially like this. If they stay a few minutes, then that's enough, no? Because if you make video, for example, for the live, I'm now live streaming 2 hours. This has been viewed 21 times. And the average view duration is 22 minutes. 22 minutes, that means I gained already 21 times. Sorry. 21. Okay. Times. Do the arithmetic. 22 equals 462 minutes divided by 60. So I gained already 7.7 watch hour for my 2 hours live stream. To gain 7 hours of watch time using relying on your video, 3 minute video or 5 minute video, you must be viewed, right? Okay, times 60 again, this one. You must be 462 minutes, but your video is only 4 minutes, so divide natin, for example, 4 minutes. It must be viewed 100 times. Or 115 times. You cannot get a view, a number that much if you are a new small channel. You will not be able to gain 115 views. This will take days, weeks, and months before it reaches 100 views. That's why now I'm just focusing live streaming to gain watch hour faster. I don't know, I wasn't as sure, but now I am. Thank you. Thank you if you subscribe. I'm just 58. You are now maybe the 60. You are the 59. I just have a 59 subscriber. You are now the 68th subscriber. Thank you very much. Like PRB. Do you have a channel on PRB? I'll visit your channel too if you'd like. I'll check on you. So anyway, sometimes you do YouTube, so it's better just publish it, you know, for something. You don't really have to worry with viral or not, just keep publishing it. Then when you have this critical mass a little bit, before you reach critical mass, you just have accomplished all the requirements of the YouTube. Then that's, for me, on my opinion, is where you develop your channel. You can develop it right now, why not? But if developing it takes time, then you lose time. So you just, you know, maybe halfway and so on, so you just time it all together. You don't waste too much time, because if you rely only on your videos, even though it looks really really nice and good, even for small channel, it will not gain traction, because the YouTube, they will only give you a, let's say, 24 hours for your video to take off. Once after 24 hours, it will not be recommended that much. It will flatten out, it will plateau. So you got stuck. Meaning, your video must be viral within 24 hours. And I am not Mr. Beast. I cannot do that. I don't know. Yeah. Yes. So anyway, very nice talking to you, Lag PRB. I hope you enjoyed just talking to me. So anyway, what time is it? In my time, it's 2:30 a.m. From where are you, PRB? Right now, I think it's now time to sleep. And actually, the next target now is this part here, which is the lovers and things like that, no? If I check on our references. Rather than, oh, this lovers, very quick, this one. This also, this simple hatch here. That is not done. That's not big problem. Here. So we have only a very few things left. Here, the lovers here. I enjoyed the stream. Have a good rest of your day. Yes, thank you very much. Thank you. It's a bit early in the morning now, my time. And although I hate to stop while we're having a very good and nice discussion and night talk, because you're the only one here, so we talk person to person. There's no other people here. Yeah, it's just you and me. So anyway, I will maybe resume tomorrow. I'll leave another way to keep the watch hour going. Sometimes I just leave a note here. 3D modeling will resume. Then I put a counter and just leave the light running. Keep it running. It's called silent live stream. So I'll just put a note. 3D modeling will resume after 12 hours. It's counting down. No? Counting down what time I will resume. I'll just keep it on running. After maybe 5 hours, 6 hours, when I wake up, I stop it. That way, I also gain the watch hour thing. I started this only a few days ago. So now I have a lot of them. Maybe I can finish the 4,000 watts hour doing like that. Okay, thank you very much, Lag PRB. Thank you very much. I enjoy very much. No, you are the very first time that appeared in my live that I was able to talk about 3D. Anyway, this is session 17. That doesn't mean it's 17 days I've been doing this. No, because the session, sometimes I took three sessions in a day, or sometimes two sessions in a day. Just 3 hours, 2 hour session. And that's why I always ask for indulgence, to apologize, because this is not speed modeling. This is not speed, and I don't concentrate on how to create this really fast and not waste your time. I apologize for that. Because at the moment, I'm just focusing on my requirement. Okay, thank you very much, Lag PRB. Okay, we will end this live stream soon. I will end it. Thank you. I don't spend a lot of time in YouTube Brazil, but if I catch you online, I'll sure join up. Good luck. Yes, thank you. Thank you very much. Yes. I really appreciate you joining the live stream tonight. Thank you very much. Okay. Catch you online. Yeah. And maybe next time we can help each other if we get stuck sometimes. Because how to them, make 3D models. Thank you very much, Kirby. Thank you. Like, yeah. See you. Okay, that's it. We are going to about to end the live stream because I've been running this live stream for 2 hours 18 minutes and that is enough, no? So for my live stream, thank you very much for joining my live stream and some other people that's just viewing or listening, whether they are listening on the music or listening just for me to talk and talk and talk. Thank you very much. So this is just a very big target, this thing, this time. I just put all these hinges in this thing here. Took me 2 hours. Anyway, now the next target will be those parts here in the after part. But before we do that, actually, because here in the plan, we cannot see na clearly where the plates went. So we have to fix pa the intersections of these plates. Where did they really go? For example, here we have to. I will have to check in pictures and things like that. So that makes it far longer. That will also make it longer. The modeling. Because here I cannot distinguish anywhere. So we have to fix this area. If you notice, they are not aligned, or the alignment is off, especially the plan itself, the alignment is off, and I cannot determine from the blueprint, which is free here in the internet. We are just using anything that is we can grab as free, and of course, obviously, the quality would mean that, you know, premium, not of a premium quality, just and good enough for us to use. So this one I will have to decide how to fix this. Okay, before I maybe, we can do it that already, those other things. Okay, that's for the next session. So for now, I will just leave this running, okay, until the morning. No, I will stop and resume as a silent live stream. Thank you very much. Bye-bye. Oops, sorry. Okay. Before I go, we will take a good another screenshot to our thumbnail. So there will be some difference in improvement on our thumbnail. So we will do a different one. Okay. So there is a progression in the thumbnail. Okay. I just do a screenshot. Oh well, the viewport render. Well, we can do a render image. Let's see. So, this one is, oh, that object I hide. They use the one that I use as a guide for an incline. Okay. More is that I change, and I think that is let me see, that is this. Okay, I have that. This one is. Why is this? I hid something here. Let me see and hide everything. This is the bicep or something like that. And we add another folder and separate all the areas so they are a bit organized. It's very difficult if we don't get organized. So this one, we call this bicep. There's a bicep here. So we call it bicep. And then we put everything there. Okay. This one is in the house shape. So you are going to the bicep. Okay. And also we change your name to the bicep. This hinge here also, this is a hinge, so bicep hinge. Okay, and then here, this one, it's the handle here, where did it go, that handle. We're going to the machine gun now. Lifting handle. Okay, it's the lifting handle. We put it in also on the bicep. Okay. I really wonder if get recommended. I'm just. My goodness, and it's in the tutorial, my mom, I didn't even title mine to as a tutorial, it's not a tutorial, I don't have anything there in my title, tutorial, I avoiding it, because this is not a tutorial anyway, but I just discuss it slowly and leisurely. Creating 3D, it's not even fast. So anyway, that's good, that's good. I like it. I'm a bit happy about that. So anyway, that's it. Let's try again then, just to make a good thumbnail. Mm-hmm. yung topic natin. So, okay. It's already 3 o'clock. Thank you, Anna. I was talking to you, but I think that's enough. So, log PRDs can be found on that. Okay. That's good. You see, it wasn't perfect, but I can see that. Okay, I think I have to end it now. Where is the power plant? Something like that. Maybe. International. Going to end here. I think we can do a render, just like this, right? Simple render like this. Yeah, I think that's good. Stephen Trender and good resolution. Well, just for thumbnail. Then not be accepted again. Did you save this? In our time. Really, I'm tired. What a day. So, we'll do a silent thumbnail for not manga for Hago session 17. Shade. And now I'm going through 3 hours now. Although I'm not sleepy, but I do have to stop. Okay, thank you very much, everybody. Thank you. I wonder why my live stream just ended. I get used to the method this time. Maybe I will do the faster later. Different one. Like creating a real project and so serious about creating the project. Okay. So save it. Bye bye, everybody. I have to end now. Thank you very much. The shadow, then we have the problem with our shadow. So anyway, never mind. He said goodbye. Okay, thank you everyone, bye bye. I need only 12 more minutes. Okay, let's do the 12 minutes so we are going 3 hours. Get some food. One, two, three. Okay, let's eat. This is my dinner, late dinner, early in the morning. So,